Hey, me and Matt here, and this is SummerSlam 1996, and this is pretty cool, because we're getting close to seeing what happens with the Attitude Era coming, and it's not quite there yet, but you get Stone Cold Steve Austin here. In a dark match, sporting a mustache, of all things, who defeated Yokozuna. And you know, it's just one of these things now where his character is developing. You haven't seen the finger wagging, you haven't seen the foul language. He doesn't do much of it at this point, but it's getting there. And the story is just hell. But yeah, so he defeats Yokozuna. Then we have Owen Hart, who defeated Salvio Vega. Owen Hart was still one of the best at this point. Eventually going into his own character, I think. Not sure if he was still with Bulldog and Yokozuna, but then we have the Smoking Guns, who defeated the Body Donnas and the New Rockers. Which I didn't clue in, but Leave Cassidy is Al Snow. And of course, the Godwins in a four-way elimination match for the WWF title, WWF Tag Team titles. And Smoking Guns are the new champions. Or no, they retained their championship. Sorry. So this was a good match. It's always good to see wrestlers, once again, that you will begin to recognize, because I think Al Snow left WWF and went to ECW after this. Then we have Psycho Sid, who defeated the British Bulldog. Both really good wrestlers. I wish Bulldog was still alive to go after the WWF title. It just never happened. It's a shame. It really is. Because, like I said, I would have wanted to see that. He's a tag team champion, an intercontinental champion, hardcore champion, but never a WWF champion. So, that's too bad. We do have Gold Dust with Marlena, who defeated Mark Merrill and Sable. Or was Sable. And Mark Merrill coming in from WCW was Johnny B. Bad, the flamboyant guy, Mark Merrill and Sable. So, Wildman Mark Merrill, I think, is what they went with, and then they went with Marvelous Mark Merrill afterwards. And then, of course, Gold Dust, who came into the WWF and is still relevant to this day, still there doing his thing. Although, I'm not sure what they're gonna do with their truth and Gold Dust at this point, because they're both nearing the end of their careers, I think. Whatever. He's still in the best shape of his life, is all I'm saying. Then we have Jake Roberts, who got defeated by Jerry Lawler. And they've been going back and forth, you know. And they did have a match. I thought it was this one, actually, but it wasn't. But Jerry Lawler would pull up the bar stool and, you know, pretend. He always took shots at Jake Roberts. I don't know if I ever made amends. But according to them, it was a good way to talk about alcoholism and stuff like that. Because that's what Jake was going through. Who knows what happened. In any case, Jake lost this match. And then a boiler room brawl, and Mankind defeating The Undertaker. You know, seeing Mick Foley come to the WWF, there was a thing saying that he wanted to bring the Cactus Jack character. He wasn't there yet, and McMahon decided that he needed to go with something else, hence making this Mankind character. There was some mutant leader gimmick or something, but I can't remember exactly what it was. Anyways, this was a good match, a different match than what we're used to. And Mankind beat Undertaker. And then we have the main event, Shawn Michaels, Jose Lothario, defeating Vader with Jim Cornette for the WWF title. Now this is the point where we all saw the fucking attitude of Shawn Michaels. Getting up on the top rope and, you know, breaking kayfabe, move thing, where Vader wouldn't move in the spot. To this day, I think, you know, Jim Cornette actually has it up for Shawn Michaels because of that incident. But back then, Shawn Michaels wasn't in a good place, so that's what he did. Not excusing it, that's just how it worked out, you know. And it's another shame that Vader never got the WWF title, when I think he would have been a good champion. This was due to the fact that he was another WCW wrestler. I don't know, but there you go. I think this was an okay match, despite Shawn Michaels acting like a bitch. This was a good pay-per-view all around. I think that this was the beginning stages of having wrestlers who would eventually be in one of the most popular eras of all time. And I believe next year we would start to see that. So I'll talk to you soon.